He looking at me like, go back. Go back. What you gonna go back for? So he can ruin it some more?
Hopping no Bentley, can't hop in no Porsche. Don't got me no Bentley, don't got me no Porsche. I'm whipping this sport that I drive like a sport. I'm a trend setter, pop out like a cork. I found my papers when I found the Lord. Wanna take me out, but I'm ducked in the fort. Coaches look over me cause I'm too short. So I put it behind me to start making art. I could have been dead.
What's up, Trendsetter Gang? It's your boy Prescott, and I'm back with another video, man. Today I got a story time for y'all, man. This was probably a life-changing event for me, you know what I'm saying? Cause like, I ain't never experienced nothing like this before. So after this hadn't happened, then I had a different view. I had a different perspective, a different way I look at barbers. You know what I'm saying? Like, I gotta step in your shop, and I'm gonna give you that look. I'm gonna look at you like, and then by the way you look back at me, then I'm gonna know if you can really cut. You know what I'm saying? Cause I can't have nothing like this happen to me again. And I'm not like, this was a mind blowing. Huh? This was a knee slapper, My man, let's get to this story, bro. So look, once upon a time, I was in like fifth grade at Pauline Elementary. We had a picture day coming up. And you know me, man, I'm up and I'm trying to be fresh, clean. Cleanest one at the school, you know what I'm saying? So I went, my mama, she took me to Burlington. Man, I went and got me a sports coat, the Rockwell jeans, big 99 on the back of them things, you know. Had the there wasn't no AirPods, it was like a some kind of plaid button down. So I'm, what kind of shoes I had? I think I had like some Sperry's or something, some Sperry. But hold on, somebody else.
Whoa.
So, before I was rudely interrupted, man, but Chad, so I had Sperry's, I had the Rockwell jeans, I had the button down, sports coat, fresh. Now, all right, I think this was the day right before picture day. I'm saying to myself, man, Dad, I need a haircut. So I'm gonna tell my daddy, man, Dad, I need a haircut. All right. Man, we go pull up at my barber. Been getting blessed by Snoop all my life. Getting blessed by Snoop, you know. And then, man, Snoop list was full. And if you go to Snoop now, you already know his list be full, like, every day. Except for Tuesdays. Catch him on a Tuesday, you gonna get your cut. But, his list full. So then, alright. So I was getting cuts by Damien, too, at the time. Damien. He wasn't really a barber, but he knew how to cut hair, you know what I'm saying? So I could just call him up. I either go to his house or he come to my house. Give me a fresh one. Blessed. He had work that day. He had work. Couldn't cut me. So we hadn't been to no other barbers before. I lied. I hadn't been to Marshall. I don't know what happened, why I didn't go to him. But look, we ain't go to Marshall. So look, they had one more barber. One more. That we never tried. So my dad like, well look, he cut her, let's go try him out. Man. So I'm in fifth grade, man. I ain't really worried. I mean, I was worried about looking good, but I wasn't really thinking, man, oh, he gonna mess my head up. I wasn't thinking like that. So look, man, we pull up over the to the man's shop. I ain't gonna name who this man is, cause I don't wanna corrupt his business or nothing. Have people thinking, well, I'm not going to real. Which I suggest you. Just like I said, man, you walk up and up, give him that look. And then you gonna know, you gonna automatically know if he good, you know what I'm saying? You gonna know about the habits of your head. But so I get up and up. We might have had like two people up and up. My daddy, he dropped me off. It's my turn to get up in the chair, man. I get up in the chair. And man, he said, what you want? I said, I don't know. I didn't know what the haircut was. And then he looked at my head, I guess. He looked at it. It was like something like this, you know, a little cut. So I was getting low cuts back then. And so he just assumed that I was getting a low cut, same thing, you know. So I'm like, cool. And then, nah, this was the crazy part. When this man started my haircut, he went straight to the line. This man put me in the chair, pumped the chair up, grabbed the liners, and put it to my forehead. Now, me being, how old I was? I was like 11, I think. Yeah, I was about 11. I'm not thinking about the process of getting a haircut. But I know all my life, been going to Snoop, getting blessed by Snoop. He ain't never started on my liner. So I'm thinking, all right, this a little strange, a little fishy situation. So look, haircut going straight. I guess that was like a little warm up on the line. He just cut it up, you know. He outlined it, I guess you could say. He outlined my line. So then he cut the got the other clips or whatever. Started cutting out the top, Boom. Midway through my haircut, this man put the clippers down. Said he gonna be right back. All right, he put the clippers down and went outside. Man, another customer came and opened that door. I'm sitting in the chair, I look outside. This man is smoking a Black & Mild.
You're killing me, Smalls.
Black & Mild. But look, boom. He up in there. I mean, he out there smoking a Black. A couple minutes later, he come back in the shop. Grab the clippers. Go back to cutting my hair. Boom, boom, boom. Cutting. Boom. And then, alright, so now I guess he done finished the top off, finished all that around up. I don't think I was getting a fade at the time, but he had to cut that, and then he come back to my lining. He lining me. I'm thinking everything going all smooth and good. All smooth. But then a man start brushing my face off, brushing the hair off my face. He put a little all this stuff. Call it the aftershave or whatever you want to call it. He put that on my line and all that. I got it, y'all. Look in the mirror. Man, I swear to God, I was the cleanest person, dog. I said, man, I'm about to go back to Snoop. Tell Snoop starting on my line at first. Tell Snoop take a little break in between. Refresh his mind, all that. I'm about to tell Snoop this. So he could give me, like, how this man had done got me. Man, I swear to God, I was so clean, son. Crispy line. Man, my daddy pull up. I get up in that truck. And my daddy start looking at me funny, son. Man, my daddy looking at me like, he wasn't really laughing. He was like, I guess he was like shocked or whatever. He looking at me like, man, what's going on? Like, something looked strange to him. I'm like, I was smiling me. Looking jolly. Just got the fresh one. And then I said, Dad, what you looking at? I'm like, I'm confused because he's looking at me funny. Then he said, he did a little chuckle. He went like that. And then he said, are you lying and crooked?
Boy, if you don't get,
I said, what you mean? Thought that was a fresh one, you know what I'm saying? I'm confused, huh? What you mean? Man, I flipped that mirror down up in the car, look up in that thing. And I still thought it was clean. Me, you know what I'm saying? I thought it was clean. And then he was like, boy, RJ, you don't see that? And I'm like, what you talking about? Then my daddy pulled my chin to the side a little bit, straightened my head up. When I tell you my line, it was like this.
No.
That dude was, man, my line was on the slope, son.
Man, I fucked myself up, bro.
A Y equals 3 over 2 minus 4 BX, whatever you want to call it.
The other side look a little too big.
Damn, dog, I done fucked my hair up doing the fucking tutorial, man. My ramp here going downhill here.
And my stuff was really like this.
Huh? No!
Son, I was hurt, son. I was hurt. Cause I'm sitting up in the truck thinking, man, what we gonna do? What we gonna do? I gotta take pictures tomorrow, what we gonna do? So then I'm like, daddy, come on, man, let's just go back to, thing. He looking at me like, go back. Go back. What you gonna go back for? So he can ruin it some more? I said, man, you right. Man, I'm sitting there. I'm drool. I'm sitting there. Chad, there was nothing I could do, son. There was nothing I could do. But when I got home, man, I went look in the mirror some more, son. I'm sitting there looking at how my line is going like this. Man, you know what crazy, son? Like, you know how I got the little 90 degree angle, whatever, right, chop, man? My stuff was like at the bottom, son. Like, one of them was at the bottom and one was right, son. I don't know how I see that, son. I don't know how I see it. But man, I get home, like, daddy, man, you think you can fix it? He got some little clippers or whatever. Like, daddy, you think you can fix it? Like, I could try. My daddy started cutting. He straightened me up a little bit. He straightened out a little bit. My slope went from like this to but like that. It wasn't straight. But it was better than what I had, you know what I'm saying? Man, that was $15 going down the drain, man. For this man to give me a ramp on my head. But that was a lesson learned. Make sure you check your barber like this. But Chad, so pictures didn't roll around. Going up and up, I was like, you know how when you think you clean, you gonna walk up and up, looking all confident and stuff, you gonna walk up and up like, yeah, strutting, yeah. Man, I walk up and up so dead, son. I swear I ain't gonna beat up. And I went up and up, I took the pictures. Still was looking good. Man, that boy smiled, that thing said, ting. Fresh. My clothes might be brought out, son. My clothes might be brought out, son. You'll never see me in a Rockaway anymore, son. I promise. Never. But, moral of the story, man, always make sure you can trust your barber. Don't just go to anybody, son. You need to see their work or something. Make sure you're in good hands, you know what I'm saying? And for the best advice, man, go to Snoop, man. And if Damian was still cutting like that, I'll tell you, go to Damian. I trust them. Anytime, they can cut it. But that's all you got for the story, man. I hope y'all enjoy it. Make sure you smash that like button. Make sure you subscribe to the channel. Share it with your friends. Man, we got more story times coming. My boy Heavy B up y'all with me. Telling y'all more stories about some stuff that happened to us. But yeah, I'm out. Trust that again. Yeah.